Hello kids, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we have finished with our GK syllabus and right now we are going to revise few of the important topics and I'm taking all those topics from your book. And first topic, yesterday we have done revision of fishy facts and after that we have done awesome animals. Now we'll talk about useful plants today. Now in our surrounding we found different types of plants. Find different types of plants we will see in our surrounding. And from these plants, few of the plants which are quite useful. If I talk about Tulsi. So we will found Tulsi at a home. Almost everybody is having at a home. And that Tulsi is having very medicinal property and a few of the properties which is only we are getting in Tulsi itself. Apart from Tulsi, we will be getting mint, lemon and so many more plants were there. So today children, we are going to talk about some of the useful plants. And here I am going to take few of the useful plants from your book as well as outside from your book. So we'll start with your book and after that I'll tell you few of the useful plants which are not only given in your book but that plants are quite common in your surrounding and that is very much useful. So first we will start with the neem tree. Nowadays, we were having this problem of corona, that is COVID-19. And in that time, if any plant which is working like an antibiotic or that can be used to kill germs in our surrounding, so that is neem. If you will collect neem leaves, dry neem leaves and burn in a corner, then with that harmful bacteria and harmful mosquitoes, germs, those who were present in your house, that can be killed. So there are lot many useful things about neem plants. Neem plants leaves can be kept in the grain also so that other insects cannot make an impact on that. See, neem leaves are, people are tied all the neem leaves and hanging in front of their houses also. It is found that neem leaves with their neem leaves, it will create a such kind of an environment that it is working like antibiotic and it will fight. Many more medicines are made from neem leaves. One who is suffering from diabetes. Diabetes is what means when our body is not able to make sufficient amount of insulin to digest sugar, then that person is, I'll repeat it, that hamari body mein sugar ko digest karne ke liye we required insulin in our body. Aur jab kisi bhi person ki body mein that insulin is not getting formed, then we'll say that that person is suffered from a disease which names diabetes. Abhi common language mein main hum usko sugar bhi bol dete hai ki okay, fine, that person is suffering from sugar. So sugar is also a common word. Or what else? Medicinal property hai, so that is used in soaps also, different medicines also. And to ward off insects also. So lot many uses of these neem plants. So first we have done about neem plants. It can be used as antibiotic at home to kill and to ward off germs, to ward off insects in your house. It can be put it inside the grain also to remove insects. Soaps are made from neem leaves. Neem leaves are tied with a rope and it can be hung on the door because it is are working like an antibiotic, so lot many important properties of neem. And neem you will find in your surrounding. If you will see in your surrounding now, you will most commonly you will find it out neem. And that neem is having these many properties. But although neem is having that many property, itni sari properties hone ke baad bhi, the people, those who are not growing plants and growing trees in their surrounding. Now we'll come to second tree, that is coconut tree. Now coconut tree is quite useful. Coconut tree is quite useful. Why it is quite useful? Because coconut tree is coconut water is quite refreshing, and after that coconut tree is also used for that coconut fruit is also used for making chutneys. It is used in different dishes, and in southern area, if you will go there, you will find it out maximum of coconut trees. And they were using that coconut ped ke jo patte hote hai, that are quite big one, huge one, usko kya karte hai, wo they were used to put it on their houses, jo unke animals ko rakhne ke liye extra jo bhi saman hai for keeping that thing. They were making that house, and that house is covered with that kind of a with that coconut leaves. Now coconut water makes for a cool refreshing drink. Coconut fiber, the outer covering of that coconut fiber is used to make which is called coir, that is used to make ropes, mats, and that can be woven into different things. So that is coconut tree. In this way coconut tree is quite useful. Actually the trunk, the lower portion of that coconut is quite strong, that can be used to make furniture also. So that is coconut tree. Every part of the banana tree, next tree is banana tree. Again banana tree is also a very important tree. And we often found in our surrounding. Banana tree, we can get bananas from banana tree, that is there. But the trunk, flowers and fruit, each part of banana tree can be eaten. Fruit, flowers and banana, their trunk also, each part of that banana tree can be eaten. That can be utilized in some, in one way or in another way. In fact, the leaves are also used for serving food in south. In even in a huge restaurant also, bade bade restaurant and hotels maybe, they were used banana leaves plates and banana leaves only to serve the food. So this banana tree is also very important. Now we'll come to a next plant, that is henna plant. Henna plant is used to color hands, hair and fingernails, and in fact fabric also. For coloring the fabric also we will be using this henna plants. And isko hindi mein hum will called it mehndi also. And iski jo dye hoti hai, that is color which they will give, that is reddish brown dye, which is used to put it on hands and hairs also, and on fabric also. This henna plant is used for printing. Now the last tree which we are going to do it, that is, or the last tree, that is rubber tree. So the chapter which we have done different landforms, in that chapter I have told you that we will found different medicinal plants and rubber tree in forest. and this rubber tree is keep on leaving a fluid that is called latex, which is used to form tires, shoes, sole, and even rubber balls also will be made from that latex only. So this rubber tree is leaving that latex, which is used to make many more things. This latex, the liquid which came out from rubber tree, is called latex. It's very important. So apart from this, you will find it out many more plants. In your quick quiz, you can see that what are the different useful plants apart from these three, these five which we have done: neem plant or neem tree we have done, then coconut tree, banana tree, then henna plant and rubber tree. Now children, we'll come to our next one, which is quick quiz, that is, can you identify these commonly used medicinal plants? Now what are medicinal plants? What are medicinal plants? What are medicinal plants? Medicinal plants are those plants which are used for some medicine purpose. Like if you are suffering from cough and cold, then tulsi ki chai jo hum peete hai, that is quite useful. So tulsi is one of the medicinal plant. First of all, I'll write these medicinal plant tulsi first, and then we have mint, we have this mint, and the third one is we have this amla. So these three medicinal plants have been given in your book. Now about tulsi, if you are suffering from cough and cold, you will find it out that it is quite useful. It is quite useful to drink tulsi ka kadha or tulsi, a tea which is made up of tulsi. So now tulsi ki chai jo hoti hai, that is very much beneficial for cough and cold. Now we'll come to mint. Mint aapne pudin hara, the name of the medicine you have heard. Fine. Pudin hara aapne suna hoga, you have seen that green color tablet also. So that is very good for your digestion. If you will be suffering from stomach or your digestion is not proper, then you can use this mint. Aap pudine ko apna ghar mein bhi, mint ko Hindi mein pudina bolte hai. Mint ko you will crush it and make a liquid and drink it. That will be very good for digestion. Now we'll come to the third medicinal plant, that is amla. Now amla is very much useful for your hair. Hair, because in amla we have vitamin C, which is very good for your growth of your hair. It will make your hair black, more black. So that is very good for your tooth and gums also. So these are few of the medicinal plants which we found in our surrounding. We use it, but we are not aware of all those useful properties of these plants. So children, what we have done today related to useful plants till now, first five trees, that is neem tree having many medicinal property, used in making antibiotic, used in making soaps, and we can burn the neem leaves to ward off insects. Then coconut tree, coconut fruit is quite useful. In fact, the trunk of that coconut tree is quite strong, which is used to make furniture. Then we'll come to, and one more thing, that outer covering of that coconut, which is called coir. Coir is used to make robes and mats. Now we'll come to fourth one, that is third one, that is banana tree. Each part of this banana tree is useful. In fact, the fruit can be eaten, that part of that stem can be eaten, their flowers can be make different dishes. Then henna plant. हिना प्लांट इज यूज टू गिव कलर आइदर टू योर हेयर टू योर नेल्स और टू द फैब्रिक ऑल्सो नाउ हिना प्लांट वी ऑफन फाइंड इट आउट इन आर सराउंडिंग नाउ विल कम टू नंबर 5 दैट इज रबर ट्री रबर ट्री इज लीविंग अ लिक्विड विच इज कॉल्ड लैटेक्स एंड वॉट द पीपल वर डूइंग दे विल पुटिंग देयर वन सम कंटेनर टू कलेक्ट दोज latex and industries are collecting those latex and providing it with the product of which is made up of rubber like your rubber sole is made up of that tire is made up of with that eraser and many more things were made with that rubber tree although with that latex only but latex we are getting from rubber tree only Now we have done in different forms that we are getting different medicinal plants from forest. So medicinal plants, if we talk about medicinal plants, few of the medicinal plants we are getting at a home also like tulsi, mint and amla. Tulsi is very good in cough and cold. Mint is very good for digestion and amla is very good for your growth of your hairs. They can be make your hair more blacken so these are few of the useful plants which is given in your book that you will do it now children we are going to take few more plants and then find it out how these plants are useful so let's start that So now few more medicinal plants and their property will do it. That is tulsi, mint, we have done aloe vera, right? And this medicinal plant, in medicinal plants, we will consider this aloe vera also. And this aloe vera is very important for your skin. If you want to be young or nowadays you will be getting different aloe vera gel face wash and what you are getting that different aloe vera juice is also available in the market now what is important in aloe vera is having that jelly like consistency that is material which is considering in that aloe vera that is jelly like substance and that jelly like thing is quite useful for your skin to make you young and make you more brighter that aloe vera is quite useful now with this next plant or the next medicinal that is fenugreek what is the other name of fenugreek is methi aapke ghar mein hogi aapne dekhi hogi methi and plant is also available plant is also there and seeds are we are taking out seeds from those fenugreek plants and this fenugreek seeds are quite important aapko digestion se related kuch problem hai if you having arthritis if you have any problem related to your bones I'm not saying that you will be having that problem but if anyone is having that points problem related to joints so these plants are quite useful So this fenugreek is useful like this. Apart from this, agar if I'll talk about few more medicinal plants, then fennel. Fennel means sauve, and that is again it is used for your digestion. So number 3 we can write fennel. Now these plants are not given in your book, but these plants are also same importance as the useful plants which is given in your book. Now. Now so many other plants which are quite useful that is a list of plants is there the few important plants we have done now I will do few of the questions that is related to your useful plants so now children we will do few of the questions that is related to your useful plants and you will give answers to that questions first question which of the following plant is a herb which of the following plant is a herb. Fine. And I'm going to write this question and with that examples. That part also we'll write. First question is, which of the following plant is a herb? Plant is a herb. I've told you just now that herb means which is having some kind of a medicinal property also. So what are the example here options? That is mango. B part is mint. Hibiscus. And D part is coconut. Now these are also useful plants, like mango is also useful plant, hibiscus is also a flowering plant, but coconut is also useful plant. But the question is, which of the following plant is a herb? Which of the following plant is a herb? So here mint is considered as a herb. Fine, mint matlab, just now I have told you that is called pudina, and that pudina is quite useful for your digestion. Now question number 2, which of these is an important function of the roots of a plant? Which of these, I'll read out the options and you will be telling that what is the important function of that roots of a plant. First, to absorb oxygen from the atmosphere, to absorb carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, to absorb water and minerals from the soil, or all of these. What is the important function of roots? What is the function of roots? So here the function of roots is to absorb water and mineral from the soil. Now here what we will do, we have different parts of the plant, and I have told you earlier also that what are the different parts of plant and what are their different functions. So in that only I have told you roots are used to find out or to absorb water and mineral from the plants. Now, which kind of a tree is commonly found in desert? Question number 2. Which kind of a tree or plant? Right? Which kind of a plant are commonly found in desert? What are the plants which are commonly found in desert? So here are the option are mango tree, cactus, neem tree, none of these. So we all are aware that cactus we found in the desert. Why? Because cactus has a fleshy stem which helps to retain water in the plants, and water will not be lost in that kind of a plant. So cactus is quite common in the desert. Now next question, the leaves of dash are used as food. So onion, cabbage, eggs and ginger. So cabbage leaf is used as a food. Now which of these is a creeper? Now what are creeper and climbers? Creeper are the plants which moves only on earth surface and then they are growing. climbers which with us the plants which with some support they will climb over there. So which of these is a creeper? That is pumpkin, money plant, cactus, and none of these. So here pumpkin is a kind of a creeper. Okay, now we'll start with next important question, that fruit is developed from flowers. Now next question we'll do it. Which of these is not a plant? Which of these is not a plant? Neem tree, mushroom, mango tree, and coconut tree. So, what is the correct answer? The correct answer is cactus. Cactus is not a kind of a tree. Now, question number 3. Which of these is obtained from plants? Obtained from plants. So out of the given option you have to tell me that out of these, which of these is obtained from plants? Paper, animals, medicine, both A and C. Yes, both. We will find it out, paper also from the plant and medicine also. Medicine also we will find from plants. So now next question we'll take it. Oil is abstained from which of the following plant? Means from which plant that oil can be obtained? That is mango plant, sunflower plant, mustard plant, and coconut plant. So out of this, abstain means which cannot be found. So oil is not obtained from mango plant. Fine. From mustard plant also we will find oil. From coconut plant also we can find oil. From that sunflower plant also we can found oil. But from mango tree we cannot found oil. So here the answer is mango tree. Now one more question. What is the properties of herbs? That herbs are the small plants having soft stem, and they can be grow itself, but they will not be grown in much higher size. So what we have done today, we will finish our class over here. We have done about many of the things related to useful plants, different medicinal plants also we have seen from your book as well as from outside the book. Few of the question also we have taken from useful plants. Children, now what you have to do, you have to see the video, revise all these topics along with the video, and then question I am going to ask from all these topics which we are revising it into class in the next evaluation or in the class test also. So it is very important to revise with the question. In every video I am taking few of the questions related to that particular topic. Revise all these video, all these questions from the video. In your last Saturday class also I have taken 15 GK questions, that also you have to revise. Revise today we have done about different plants, useful plants. Then we have done about medicinal plants. Then we have done about herbs. What are the different functions of different parts of the plants? That also we have seen. So all these things you are going to revise according to topic. So I hope you all have enjoyed today's session. Here I am going to finish our class. That's all for today, children. Have a good day.